Einstein published his theory of general relativity in the year 1915, and since then this theory has been our best description of gravity. It has been verified multiple times and has given very accurate results. But still, it isn't correct. It can't be correct, at least not fundamentally. We are certain that there must be something much deeper about gravity. And even Einstein kind of knew this. In a 1916 paper, he wrote, quantum theory would have to modify not only Maxwellian electrodynamics, but also his new theory of gravitation. Now, general relativity is a truly elegant and beautiful way to model gravity. The most interesting thing about general relativity is that it explains gravity not as a force, but rather as an effect of the space-time geometry. Essentially, what it says is that mass or energy warps space-time. So when an object moves through this warped space-time, their paths appear to be curved. Not because there is a force acting on the object, but because the space-time it is moving through itself is curved, which gives us the illusion that a force is acting on the object. And general relativity has since been verified many times. There's no questioning there. Black holes, gravitational waves, gravitational lensing, all of these things have been predicted by general relativity and since been verified to be correct. So why do we think that it can't be how gravity fundamentally works? Well, because general relativity doesn't take into account quantum effects, which we know to exist in the universe. Superposition, entanglement, general relativity has nothing to say about it. So for example, if an electron can be in a superposition of being at multiple places at once, where would gravity be? General relativity and quantum mechanics are fundamentally incompatible. These are based on entirely different ideas. They speak different languages. They do not go hand in hand. The reason we usually don't encounter any discrepancy in our experiments is because we almost never have to invoke both of these theories together for anything. Both of these theories work at entirely different length scales. At the quantum scale, the effects of gravity are so feeble that it almost don't exist and you can just ignore it. And at the scale where gravity becomes important, quantum mechanics loses its distinctive probabilistic nature. This happens with gravity because gravity is incredibly weak. It is about 10 to the 40 times weaker than the electromagnetic interaction. Now the problem with general relativity does become apparent at really small length scales, especially when the energies involved are really high, such as at the centers of black holes and the Big Bang. Here general relativity predicts the existence of space-time singularities. A singularity is a point where all geodesics end and the energy density becomes infinite. Which, to be frank, so general relativity has broken down and is not an accurate description of the universe at those scales. In these situations, we cannot get away without quantum mechanics, because in both of these situations, the length scales involved are quantum and the energies are such that gravity cannot be ignored. And the world we live in is not divided into microscopic and macroscopic. The world is one. It can't be the case that two mutually incompatible theories are fundamental. There must be a grander theory which incorporates both of these theories in appropriate length, energy and time scales. A theory of gravity that takes into account quantum effects and in a sense quantizes gravity to be able to explain what really exists inside the black hole or in the beginning, the Big Bang. A theory of quantum gravity. And this idea is not really new. We have been able to get a quantum description of all of the other forces in the universe. Electromagnetism, strong, weak nuclear force have all been quantized under the framework of quantum field theories. The basic idea is that in quantum field theories, the most fundamental objects in the universe are not particles but are fields. These fields permeate the entire universe and particles are just locations where any particular field has high enough energy. So in this view, electrons aren't really ball like particles. Instead, these are excitations of the electron field that permeates the entire universe. These fields can interact with each other, which results in all of the things that we experience. There are fields that transmit forces and there are fields that make up all of the matter we see around us. For example, the excitation of the electromagnetic field results in photons which transmit the electromagnetic force between charged particles. And this is why many people believe in the existence of gravitons, which are theorized to be the quantum of the gravitational field and are supposed to transmit the gravitational force. Now it might feel weird to you, as it did to me, because I thought gravity is the result of the space-time curvature and it's not really a force. Then what's the point of having gravitons to mediate a force that isn't really a force? Well, the point is that, first of all, not all theories of quantum gravity have gravitons as fundamental entities. And second, those that do are trying to explain the same phenomena using other fundamentals. As I understand, gravitons and curved space-time are not really competing ideas, but rather they are supposed to be complementary to each other. In a sense, the curved space-time we macroscopically observe is the result of the coherent state of a large number of these graviton particles. Gravitational waves, for instance, in general relativity, are kind of ripples in the space-time fabric. It's like when you move your finger in water, waves appear. But in the case of quantum mechanics, these gravitational waves would be composed of a large number of graviton particles, just like how the light that we can see is nothing but a large number of photons. And naturally, attempts have been made to create a valid quantum theory of gravity. The most straightforward way for this was to directly quantize the gravitational field of general relativity, as we would have done to any other force. But this is when the incompatibility between general relativity and quantum mechanics really comes at the forefront, because gravity is kind of an odd one out among all of the forces in the universe. Unlike any other force, the gravitational field of general relativity is not just a field on top of some background space. Instead, it is space-time. It is the background through which everything moves and in which everything exists. So we are in general relativity, we have this background which is dynamic. It can bend or curve depending upon the distribution of energy in that space, or it is background independent. At the same time, quantum mechanics requires a fixed, non-dynamic, usually a flat Minkowskian background on top of which all of the other fields that correspond to different particles exist. That means quantum mechanics is background dependent. And then there's the problem of time. Both of these theories treat time very differently. In general relativity, the flow of time is relative and it depends upon each observer individually. Whereas in quantum mechanics, the flow of time is this eternal absolute flow that ticks at a rate no matter what's happening in the universe. Additionally, when you quantize the gravitational field of general relativity, you are in some sense quantumizing space-time itself. And if space-time has quantum properties, we expect fluctuations in the space-time, which would be in direct contradiction with general relativity, which requires for a smoothly curving space-time. So yes, quantizing gravity is a mess. There are dozens of approaches to quantum gravity. Different approaches have different ideas. Some try to modify general relativity to make it talk quantum, while others try to describe gravity in purely new ways. There are two main approaches that we'll be briefly discussing in the next segment, but remember, by no means are these the only candidates to try to solve the problem. Let's start. String theory and loop quantum gravity are two of the most famous approaches to quantum gravity. String theory says that all of the particles in the universe are actually vibrating one-dimensional strings, and the different vibrational patterns of these strings behave like different particles. The most interesting thing this idea offers is that you automatically get a particular string vibration that matches exactly with the properties we expect from gravitons. Loop quantum gravity, on the other hand, introduces us to ultra-microscopic structure of space-time. It says that space-time at the most fundamental level is composed of loops and nodes, and the different structures and like geometry of these loops gives rise to space-time we see at the macroscopic scale. This theory tries to explain gravity in a purely geometric way. Instead of treating gravity as a force, this theory builds up on Einstein's theory of general relativity, and instead tries to modify the space-time geometry at the quantum level. An implication of which is that space-time is viewed to be discrete. There's a smallest space, there's a smallest time, smallest volume area, and so on. However, both of these theories have problems, and by no means are complete. And it is very much likely to be the case that if we ever get to a theory of quantum gravity, it will look a lot different than the views presented by any of these theories. The point is that we still don't really understand gravity. The best theory of gravity we have, general relativity, works really, really well for more than 99% of the universe. But still, it cannot be 100% correct. To add, we shouldn't forget about dark matter and dark energy, as these are in some sense have resulted from general relativity and might be in need of revision once we get to a theory of quantum gravity. Okay, so that's all I have for today. Thanks for watching. I'm gonna see you in my next video. Bye.